sponsored by IXL Productions.
My name is Sarah O'Brien and I'm a Learning Support Assistant at Newman Catholic College in Harlesden, London, Northwest 10. I've been here for about 10 years and for the past 5 years I've worked with Marcus Green, who are the candidates that I've nominated. He came into year 7 as an 11-year-old boy, and I worked with him consistently one-to-one basis till he was 16. And he is currently at St. Charles's College, and he's studying 3 A-levels, sport, ICT and business.
My name is Ken Hughes, I'm from Newman Catholic College, I'm the head of religious education. When he came in year 7, he had a statement of special educational needs. So obviously there were some sort of concerns about his educational attainment. Now looking at his statement, it seems to specify that he had a specific learning difficulty, specifically dyslexia. So therefore there was obviously concerns from at the very, very beginning in year 7. Now at the time when he came into the school, he had sort of quite low self-esteem. And also I know in the past, I think he felt frustrated by his academic ability and by the fact that he couldn't do maybe things that other pupils in his class could do.
This is behaviour when he came into Newman Catholic College was a bit challenging, to say the least. He came from Salisbury Primary School, and in year 6 they came for a visit for the day into Newman Catholic College, and he was looking around the school and he said that he doesn't really like school, but sometimes he finds it a bit difficult. And in year 6 in primary school, they used to call him the killing machine because he was very tall, very big, even at that age in year 6. And he'd tried other schools and they weren't willing to accept him, but Newman Catholic College accepted him. And he started off, he's got a statement for EBD, which is emotional behavioural difficulties, and a statement for severe dyslexia. So one was to do with education side, and one was to do with the behavioural side.
Well, the expectations of all the pupils in our school is to try and get them C's and above, obviously. But obviously we know that for having something specific such as dyslexia, there's going to be more barriers to attainment than for any other students who wouldn't have any of these specific learning difficulties. So therefore, in a sense of sort of like trying to make judgments from year 7, well, it's always a case of like put the interventions in place and see what happens from there. However, with Marcus, well, Marcus was very, very positive from the very, very beginning. However, it's a sense of low self-esteem. So therefore, we kind of felt with his attitude and the right attitude and sort of an aptitude to work, you were hoping that by putting the right intervention and strategies in place, that he would make that progress. But however, at year 7, because he was very, very weak, therefore, obviously, you're going to sort of treat it a little bit more carefully and try and measure it in a way where you're going to try and maybe structure him to try and give him some success. Although at year 7, at that stage, you can't notice that it's going to be quite difficult.
Behaviour has improved 100% since he came 5 years ago. He's a very polite young man, he's very conscientious. Everybody likes him in the school, and he comes to visit back in the school quite a lot. His behaviour is 100% turnaround because he was a very angry, violent young man.
Eventually, when Marcus scored an A star in his GCSE in year 11, I think it was an incredible achievement. It's an A star for any young man doing GCSE, I think, is a fantastic achievement. Yet for someone like Marcus, who started off at a very low level with a specific learning difficulties in year 7, with low self-esteem, to therefore overcome all of these barriers and to therefore at the end attain, I think is a fantastic achievement. Now I think a lot of that is down to his aptitude, in the sense of that he applied himself. Secondly, in the sense of his attitude as well. Now it wasn't easy all the way through because of his low self-esteem. He got frustrated quite a lot in his 5 years when I taught him in RE. But, however, the one big thing about Marcus was his character, in the sense that he was able to take advice, even at times when at first he wouldn't maybe necessarily agree with the advice. He'd go away and think about it for 24 hours, and he'd always come back to you and go, well, I thought about this, and in fact, you're right, I'd like to try this piece of advice or new strategy. And from there, I think that's when Marcus began to definitely flourish. And even though he had knockbacks, especially, specifically, I think back to maybe the second last mock exam that he did before the GCSEs, where he just missed out on a C, but he took that advice on board quite seriously, well, very seriously, took it with the right attitude, put it into all the advice I gave him into practice, revised, worked hard, attended revision sessions, had great support at home because his mum has always been a fantastic support, and therefore from there then he achieved and he fulfilled his ability and his potential, which we knew he could, but we felt that this is definitely a special achievement for someone who had dyslexia and had quite severe dyslexia at the beginning of year seven.
2 years ago, Marcus won the award for Jack Petchy in Brent. I was very proud of him then, and the awards were held locally. So hopefully he'll do well in the Pride of Brent Awards this year.
Congratulations on being nominated. I feel I'm sure that everybody who's been nominated is a special character. But I think Marcus is definitely a very special character and definitely deserves recognition or possible sort of like to win this award because of determination, aptitude, sort of grim determination that you need to in order to succeed and overcome your barriers. And I felt Marcus has done that, and he's always done that in good humour, and he's always done it in the sense of being a personable young man, in fact tending to be a well-rounded individual around school as well.
I'd like to wish Marcus all the best for the future. Good luck for the Pride of Brent Awards. I know you can do it. I'm very proud of you, as are the rest of my family. And I hope you do well in your A-levels, you continue to do well in your A-levels, and that you go on to, I know you've applied to universities, I hope you do well in getting into university next year. All the best.